that she might advance your heavenly kingdom, and gave her zeal for your church and love for your people. Mercifully grant that we who commemorate her this day may be fruitful in good works and attain to the glorious crown of your saints through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated.
Find. She is more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works with willing hands. She is like the ships of the merchant. She brings her food from far away. She rises while it is still night and provides food for her household and tasks for her servant girls. She considers a field and buys it. With the fruit of her hand, she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength and makes her arms strong. She perceives that her merchandise is profitable. Her lamp does not go out at night. She puts her hands to the distaff, and her hands hold the spindle. She opens her hands to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm today, appointed for today, is Psalm 146, verses 4 to 9. It's found on the Book of Common Prayer on page 803. We will read in unison, 4 to 9. Happy are they who have the Lord of Jacob for their help, whose hope is in the Lord their God, who made heaven and earth, the seas and all that is in them, who keeps his promise forever, who gives justice to those who are oppressed and food to those who hunger. The Lord sets the prisoners free. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord cares for the stranger. He sustains the orphan and widow, but frustrates the way of the wicked. The Lord shall reign forever. Your God, O Zion, throughout all generations. Alleluia.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, Lord Christ. Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in the field, which someone found and hid. Then in his joy, he goes and sells all he has and buys that field." Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls. On finding one pearl of great value, he went and sold all that he had and bought it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
I want to invite the kids to come up and join me this morning. You may be seated. Good morning. You all are wearing beautiful plaids today. Do you know why you're wearing beautiful plaids today? Come sit. Anybody know? St. Margaret's Day. St. Margaret's Day is today, right? So, she was a queen. Do you know what? Scotland. Yeah? Pretty cool, huh? She lived. Can you? There were like faithful Christian people. It was after dinosaurs, but yeah. Know what she was known for? What is she? Elise? What?
Her jewels.
Her jewels. Ooh, did she have jewels?
I mean, she was a queen. I'm pretty sure she probably had some.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Her kindness to her people. That's exactly right. Did you know
that she loved people so much, her people so much, that the people who were poor, the people who were hungry, the people who, were dirty, clothes or any of the
she would bring them into her dining hall, her royal dining hall, and she would feed
them and she would tend to them.
If they were sick,
she would tend to the sick, and she would even go so far as to wash their feet. She would wash their feet. Like if their feet were dirty, she would wash their feet. That's pretty nice, right? Yeah. Who else do we know that washed feet?
Jesus
did. That's right. So,
and that's really the point. Margaret did all that because she believed so passionately in Jesus. That she believed
that the way that Jesus loved people in the world was something that she could do in her time. And that she could love people and she could care for people so much like Jesus that it would make a difference in the world. And that's really what she did. She was really faithful in prayer. She prayed a lot. She went to church a lot. She all of that was what informed her. The more that she prayed, church, the more that it brought her not just closer to God, but closer to those in her community. Because she she did something really important. She took that prayer and she turned it into action. Have you ever thought about that? Turning prayer into action? What's a, like, what do you, when you think about prayer, what do you think that you do when you pray? Yeah. Talk to Jesus. And like you hold your hands a certain way and maybe bow your head and close your eyes, right? But what Margaret teaches us, what she reminds us, is that prayer is also action. Okay? Do you know what action is? What is action?
When you move.
When you do stuff, right? So we can sit here all day. We can say, Lord, please be with all those who are sick and hungry and all that. And we could sit here and we could pray that. And that's good. But that prayer is intended to move us out into the world, just like it did Margaret, to help people and to be nice and kind and compassionate to all people, right? So what are some actions you think that are good that we could do? Yeah, Jasmine?
Eating?
Absolutely. Eating is a wonderful action that we're going to do right after the service. Fellowship and eating together. Who gets to be a part of eating together?
Your family and maybe everybody. Like if we open up the table like St. Margaret did, then
everybody can eat, right? So, okay, what's another action? What's another action we could do? Yeah?
Helping people if they're in need.
If they say, I'm in need and they need something, then what do?
We help them.
That's right. Yeah, Elise?
Picking up trash outside
and caring for the earth. Absolutely. Good answer. All of these are good answers. Yes, ma'am? Yes, absolutely. So, the point is that all of us, because of our prayer, because of our worship, because of all these things that we do together here as a church community, all of these things lead us to go out and be like Margaret, who is actually being like Jesus. And so that's the thing that we have to remember today, is that while we're celebrating St. Margaret, we're really also celebrating Jesus. Because Jesus is the one who enacted the kindness and the compassion and the giving and all of the actions that Margaret did. And just like that hymn that we just sang, which is one of my favorites of all time, that hymn says, it's talking about saints, and that you and I can be saints just like St. Margaret, right? When we do what? When we help people. When we do what else? When we are kind. What else?
Helpful.
When we're helpful. What else?
When we're loving.
And helping people. Absolutely. So when we do, yeah.
Being nice.
Being nice. See, you guys got it. Okay? So keep being nice. Keep helping people. Do all that. And guess what? Someday there may be a church named after you. You think? I don't know. Maybe. Yeah. All right. Thank you. Ooh, I'm letting my little leg show there. And affirm our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Not made, but one made.
prayer, the clergy and people of St. Margaret's, Carrollton, St. Elizabeth's, Dahlonega, for all congregations seeking new or renewed direction, the bishop and people of our companion and partner diocese of Cape Coast, Ghana, and our sister parish, St. Teresa of Avila, Cape Coast, for Wilton, Mary, Melissa, Keith, Nora, Estelle, Jean, Alan, Chris, Katrina, Betty Ann, Jan, Mike, Marcia, Laura, Dan, Shirley, Debbie, Ann, Sophie, Allison, Noel, Lily, Journey, Melissa, Walter, Landon, Jessica, John, Judy Bumgardner, Phyllis, Cece, Mitch, Ralph, Francis, Meredith, Brenda, Peggy, Judith, the ICU staff of Tanner, our seminarians Joshua and Andrew and their families, and all who serve in the military. Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life.
For St. Margaret and for this parish and our people and our community.
We will exalt you, O God, our King. We pray for all who have died, especially David Kennedy and Cindy Prodgers, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. My friends, the peace of the Lord be always with you. To gather on St. Margaret's Day in here. Last year, St. Margaret's Day was great, but it wasn't as good as being in here with all of you. So I am just delighted to have you all with us today. There's a number of people I want to thank because there's a lot that goes into making St. Margaret's Day really special. Certainly our choir and their work and Doc and all of them, we are so grateful to them for their extra work. Also, our Buildings and Grounds Commission, who have got everything looking good on the outside of the church, and especially our Brotherhood of St. Andrew, who also helped in trimming lots of things outside. Gina, our sexton, and the number of people that she has with her, and the people and folks who helped do things like pressure wash the outside of the church and the buildings. It looks really, really great. And then, of course, our ECW, who have gone to great lengths to provide a reception
for us all. And so I am just so grateful to everybody for participating and making this day so special. And one thing I want to point out at the reception, there is a table in the corner that has kind of our history as a parish on it. And so I really want you to go over there and take a look at where we've been, how far we've come together as a group of people, as a congregation, and just check out all of the history there of our wonderful parish. So, and thank you to those of you who gathered up that stuff and displayed it as well. So lots of great things. And also I want to say thanks to Tom Crawford, our piper. Where is Tom? I don't know. He's out there somewhere. Come on out, Tom. Let's give him a round of applause. We are always glad to have you. Thank you for coming again this year and being with us. A couple of other things I want to make sure you have on your calendar. First of all, we are doing something new and different. We are taking the wonderful treasure, the gifts that we've been given, and we are taking it out into the world. And one way that we are doing that is that we are doing beer and hymns on November 21st at 4 a.m. Coffee Roasters Cafe and Bar. That will be at 7 p.m. And it's just going to be a wonderful celebration. We're going to sing some hymns. We're going to drink a few, and it's just going to be great. So I encourage you to come. Also, invite your friends. You know, if there's somebody who would appreciate just coming and being in that space with us, please invite them to come and be a part of that. That's on November 21st, which is next Sunday. Gosh, wow, yeah. Also, on December 8th, which is a Wednesday, the vestry is inviting you all and anyone else who wants to. They're gonna host another forum, and that forum is really gonna be about like what goes into being on the vestry. So if you or someone you know is looking to is discerning a call to serve on the vestry, but also if you just don't know and you want to learn more about what our vestry does, then I would really encourage you to come and that will be in the parish hall, Ryan. And what time will that be? 5:30 on December 8th. So please come and be present for that as well. All right. Let's see. We've got some birthdays and anniversaries that we want to recognize today. Sam Linnaeus, Hugh Smith, Thomas McCarthy, Jean Condry, Claudia Kennedy, Julia Bernhardt, Rick Prince, Cecia Gordon, who's turning one this week. Woo! And Marlene Uglum. Are there any other birthdays in the upcoming week that we want to recognize? All right, let's pray. Oh God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is with you and will remain with you always. Amen. And celebrating anniversaries this week, Chris and Debbie Piles and John and Cindy Hull. Are there any others? Let us pray for these couples. Grant, O God, in your compassion, that these couples, having taken each other in marriage and affirming again the covenant which they have made, may grow in forgiveness, loyalty, and love, and come at last to the eternal joys which you have promised through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. me the bread first. Eucharistic Prayer D is on page 372 in the Book of Common Prayer. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is truly right to glorify you, Father, and to give you thanks. For you alone are God, living and true, dwelling in light and accessible from before time and forever. Fountain of life and source of all goodness, you made all things and filled them with your blessing. You created them to rejoice in the splendor of your radiance. Countless throngs of angels stand before you to serve you night and day, and beholding the glory of your presence, they offer you unceasing praise. Joining with them in giving voice to every creature under heaven, we acclaim you and glorify your name as we sing.
Holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth, full of your glory.
Hosanna.
acclaim you, Holy Lord, glorious in power. Your mighty works reveal your wisdom and love. You formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that in obedience to you, our Creator, we might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again, you called us into covenant with you, and through the prophets, you taught us the hope for salvation. Father, you love the world so much that in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son to be our Savior. Incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, he lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, to the sorrowful joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, his heavenly Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Father, we now celebrate this memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and his descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given us this bread and this cup. We praise you and we bless you. We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God. Lord, we pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share this bread and cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remember, Lord, your one holy Catholic and apostolic church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. Remember all who minister in your church. Remember all your people and those who seek your truth. Remember all who have died in the peace of Christ and those whose faith is known to you alone. Bring them into the place of eternal joy and light. And grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with matriarchs, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, with Blessed Margaret, and all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God and Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. We get the other chalice.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep you in everlasting life. The body and
I
65. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have
graciously accepted us
as living
members of your Son,
our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. My friends, life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who travel with us. So be quick to love. Make haste to be kind. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is with us and will remain with us forever. Amen. peace to love and serve the Lord.